Wisdom has a price. There will always be a part of you that changes. A part of you that darkens. And a part of you that dies.
Over there.
That pool. I can feel them.
I can feel them everywhere. The lost ones.
They are watching us.
Welcome back to Senua's Saga.
Everything I've done has led me to this place.
We've come so far.
Not far enough. Say it.
You are ready.
Tell them. I am here. Now. What if we get lost forever?
What will happen to them?
What will happen to you? I will not let them down.
She is ready.
First days, the air was sweet and fresh. The ground and the sea gave up their bounty. They knew that after all their fighting, they had found somewhere to rest, somewhere to carve out a home. Askia screamed her fury. Her words blotted out the sun. She covered the green with her bitter poison and drowned the hills in bile. nothing could breathe through her hatred. All their animals choked. Their crops withered in the ground. And the people. Had to leave her home and go in search of food. But everywhere there was nothing. Where were their gods now? Drove the people to fury. As is the way of that kind, the weak lost all. Weakest of all in her arms, still she searched for a haven. But the darkness from the sky leached down. The flesh-eating ones, with the awful hunger that could never be sated, were legion. Arose, darker and more terrible than those before. She could not let the child live in such a world. So she brought her to a cave where the hidden folk were said to live, hoping they would take her child and raise her free from care, free from the darkness. She had nothing to feed her now but her rage. And despair. She made a deal. I will give myself to you, Askia, if you will give me the power to triumph in this world you have created. Take my life and give me your death.
Truth. underestimate you. You don't deserve to die here, Senua. Strong like hips, you have to hit harder.
We all know somewhere. can't approach.
Iltoiga's real name.
Inga.
Her name. Inga.
We all have names, given or chosen. We change them, charge them, invest them with meaning. Names torn away leave us raw and bleeding. Rootless. Selfless. All the names that were lost, she will fight and hold. She knows her name now. Ingun. She knows her. You know her name.
You understand her.
Not a monster after all. She is lost in her rage.
She will still kill you.
You found what you sought.
I know what they were trying to show me. I know Iltaiga's true name now. Ingun.
Names have power. True names, they cut to our hearts. To know the true name of something is to command it.
Bring her here.
Can we call to her, like the Draugr did?
She will kill you.
The Draugr were aping the costumes of the living, acting out what they did before they turned. Grotesque parody of the blood ones held in that sacred place. Sacrifices to Freya. We can call to her too. Yes. And yes, she will come. But she will kill you. Just like she has so many of us.
Then what?
She can never be reached.
We need to find a place where you can meet her face to face and see the world through her eyes.
See our world.
And there are ways of opening up the door into another space.
Another place. Fire and rage.
The veil that hides the Veridir, as they whisper.
It means us.
The veil through which you can sometimes catch a glimpse.
He understands.
There are ways to tear that open.
She knows.
Pass in.
It won't be the first time.
She's suffering. Racked with grief, I saw it.
The hidden folk showed her.
A ritual.
A ritual.
A ritual to open up the door. A ritual to heal her pain, meet her eyes, and speak her name.
A ritual. Rituals will change it.
They will bring change. They transform.
They move and change the world.
They uncover what is hidden.
Is it safe?
Never safe.
What will you do?
What?
How will you know what to do?
See the monster she has become.
So she can rest.
Rest with her baby.